Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to North Shore Live Cooper's Corner. We're live this evening, and today is June 1st. Cannot believe how quickly the days, the weeks, and now we're on the sixth month of this 12-month encounter until we get into 2017. Wow, this is really strange to hear. But I hope you had a good day. At least there was no rain that I could see. And hope your day was wonderful. And all I can say is that we hope that the sun shines 24/7 for everyone. And hope you have wonderful days ahead. This evening's program, as you know, we are live. This evening's program is Jack Musio again, because of popular demand, Chicago's most famous and favorite crooner. And Jack is sings beautiful, and when you hear him, you'll know. And we're just so pleased to have Jack. And by the way, his lovely wife, Christina, is sitting in the studio here with us. And last time she was not feeling well, we wish her much health and good health. Anyway, so without any further ado, let's get to Jack, because I want to hear his beautiful voice. And he's a pretty nice-looking guy, too, must admit that. So welcome, Jack. Again, always a good time to see you.
Wonderful time. And thank you very much again for having me again on your wonderful program.
Well, this is, you lift everyone's spirits so wonderfully. And last month in May, we had the whole month for veterans.
Yes.
And
good,
so
good cause.
It was a memorial month I made for the veterans. But people wanted to hear Jack Musio sing, and now you're back on stage in front of the cameras, and we're going to hear you sing. Tell me, what have you been up to since the last time you were on the program?
Let's see, I was on, was that April that we were together?
April, absolutely.
That was April. We were together.
Yeah.
A million years ago.
It feels like it, honest to God.
And that was one of the fastest hours of my life.
Well, and this goes fast too, what can I say?
We have so much to talk about.
That's right.
That hour just flew.
It did indeed.
But no, I've been very, thank God, been very busy. I had 13 jobs in May.
Wow.
Yeah. And two of them were brand new. Two of them were something I'd never done before.
Really?
And that was instead of being on a stage or singing in front of people, I was a singing telegram.
Huh?
Yeah. The kind where you keep your clothes on.
Okay. Okay.
Let me clarify that for everybody.
You didn't pop out of a cake. Okay. Very good.
No, I was at, there was a hairstyling studio in, you know, where they teach students to cut hair.
Oh yeah.
In Schaumburg, it was large. There was one of the instructors had a birthday, so I came and sang.
Oh, nice.
And there was about 50, 60 people there.
Oh, that's very nice.
Oh yeah.
That's nice.
And then I did another one in a bar that only, these are only about 10, 15 minutes.
But
they're wonderful.
Do you practice what you're going to sing? Do they
no.
ask you what to sing? Do they, you just pull it out of a hat? What do you do?
Sometimes they ask, but
really?
Mostly, you know, you feel the crowd, you
and
feel
you know
the
what
mood,
it is. Yeah.
You just wing it.
Go it.
Oh. The best gig I had was at the Lowe's Hotel in Rosemont. It was at 7 in the morning, and it was for the International Association of Blind Merchants.
Oh, my God.
Bev, I have to tell you, I mean, you're looking at 800 people who at best could see shadows.
800?
Oh, yeah, they have 27,000 in the United States.
Oh, my goodness.
So 800 showed up in Rosemont. They flew from all over the country. It was 7 in the morning, and I opened up. I was Frank Sinatra, and then they had the Blues Brothers. They had, Harry Carey opened up. I apologize. And I sang for these people, and they had such a good attitude. And these are people who, despite this challenge, they open up their own business. Most of them are merchants. They're retail store owners.
Really?
They do anything but feel sorry for themselves. They keep busy. They prosper, they make money, they support their
wonderful,
families.
Wonderful.
Oh, it was the most wonderful thing.
Wonderful. Oh, any, you know, from the crowd, anybody have any particular songs they wanted to hear? Or?
Well, you know, everybody wants to hear My Way.
Oh, I know, I know.
Always close the show with
Absolutely.
My Way.
Absolutely.
And favorite among women is Fly Me to the Moon. Okay. Women love that Sinatra song more than any other. Summer Wind is always a favorite. New York, New York.
Yep, that's good. Oh, so, all of it, all of them.
Yes.
There's not one I would say, no, I like better than the other. They all are wonderful.
Yes,
all
they
are wonderful.
Yes, they are.
So is that the first time you sang before this group, 800 people?
Yes. First time I sang for this.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. At 8 in the morning.
Yeah, actually it was 7:30, yeah.
Oh.
Got there at 7:30. But I was, well, when you see these people and the energy, I mean, they right away, they wake you up and you're just like, you're ready to go because there was so much energy there. You know, an entertainer, as you know, because you're in the business, you feed off of other people.
That's right.
It's like you and I talking.
That's right, back and forth. Yeah, that's
exactly.
Good.
That's why the hour goes so fast.
How nice.
Yeah.
How nice.
Yeah.
So do they have it every year here in Illinois or do they?
They switch.
They move around.
I wish they'd have it here every year because
it'd
I
be
would love
easy.
To see them again.
Yeah, well, an invitation may be handed out to you. And if they say you got to be in Texas, so you'll be in Texas or maybe Hawaii. Christina, pack your bags. So that'll be good. Yeah, that'll be excellent. Did you, because of Memorial Day, were you singing anything for Memorial Day?
Yes, Christina and I went to the Old Neighborhood Club in Chicago. Mm-hmm. And every year they have a Memorial Day service. And they have some beautiful plaques from World War II. The alderman down there is a Vietnam veteran, a former Marine. And so I had the honor of singing the national anthem.
Oh,
and then we closed up the event with God Bless America. I sang
that. Very nice. Very moving.
Tommy Lasorda was there.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, we sat, Christine and I, we had lunch with him and we sat and enjoyed his company. Yeah.
Okay.
He's a member of the club.
A member of the club,
and the Dodgers were playing the Cubs, so he's in town.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay, that was good. That was good. Well, the weather certainly didn't keep anybody down because for Memorial Day, it was a beautiful day.
Beautiful day.
Yeah, that was very nice, yeah. Well, have you got songs for us this evening?
Oh, sure, sure. You know, and I told Ken, I said, you know, let's, and this is up to you, we'll do whatever you want to do, but I said, you know, I enjoy talking more than the singing because you and I have so much fun on this show.
Well, we can talk, but I think our viewers want to hear you sing.
I'll do whatever you and they want.
Well, you know, it pleases my ear and is wonderful for my heart to hear. Go do it,
thank you, Bev.
Go do it.
Out of the tree of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along, now everything's starting to hum. Still, it's a real good bet, the best is yet to come. Best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? Think you've seen the sun, but you ain't seen it shine. Wait till the warm-up's underway. Wait till our lips have met. Wait till you see that sunshine day. You ain't seen nothing yet. Best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? Best is yet to come, come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. I'm gonna teach you to fly. We've only tasted the wine. We're gonna drain the cup dry. Wait till your charms are right for these arms to surround. Think you've flown before, but baby, you ain't left the ground. Just wait till you're locked in my embrace. Wait till I draw you near. Wait till you see that sunshine place. Ain't nothing like it here. Best is yet to come, and babe, won't that be fine? The best is yet to come. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. Come the day you're mine. And you're gonna be mine. I love Sinatra songs.
Any of his songs are wonderful. What kind of background? Can you give us some history on how he has these songs? He doesn't create these songs himself. He has a songwriter, and he sings it.
Many songwriters, to your point. Frank Sinatra recorded over 1,200 songs.
Yeah.
Many of them were from Cole Porter. Oh. Many of them were from Johnny Mercer. And then, of course, now the name escapes me, but Van Heusen, Jimmy Van Heusen.
Jimmy Van Heusen, yeah.
I mean, just wonderful writers. No, Frank never wrote music.
Is this from a movie, or this just was...
The best is yet to come. I have no idea, and I apologize.
No, not a problem.
I have no idea.
Because, some of the ones he sings were from... Guys and Dolls.
Oh, yeah, sure. Lady Luck, Luck Be a Lady.
That's right.
That's right.
Lady is a Tramp.
Lady's a Tramp. Yeah. That's from Pal Joey.
Yeah, Pal Joey.
Yes.
I don't know. Are these taken out of the plays or the pictures? Because the majority of the plays that he was in, and he was in Guys and Dolls.
Oh, yes.
And Pal Joey. So, Man with a Golden Arm.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was in that.
Phenomenal
yeah.
movie.
He was good with that. Absolutely good with that. So, now, are these taken out as singles, or are these on albums? Are these, his songs that he does? Do you know?
All of the above.
Really?
Yeah. He has many. I think his best album was September Song. It was when he turned 50 years old. And he started singing the songs, all these contemplative songs, looking back on his life, like Once Upon a Time.
I like that one.
Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, it is beautiful.
It's when Sinatra really matured. I mean, he was the playboy, like in Ocean's 11.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
And then, of course, all those movies, all the Rat Pack movies.
Yeah.
But in 1965, he did a total turnaround, and he really... Not that he was immature, I'm just saying that he took another step toward this great maturity that he enjoyed.
I wonder, is that when he married Barbara Marx? He could have...
Actually, to your point, he married Mia Farrow in 1965.
Oh.
Yes.
That only lasted a year.
That lasted, a very short time.
That was a May-December wedding thing.
Yeah, definitely.
So,
definitely.
Do you think that some of these situations... are more for celebrity gossip than it is for,
Could be. Everything I read, they met by accident. They were shooting, Frank Sinatra was shooting Von Ryan's Express.
Oh, I saw the picture.
Movie.
Yeah, I remember seeing it.
And Mia Farrow was shooting a movie, or either that or she was on the stage of Peyton Place. And she didn't even know who Frank, according to the story, she didn't even know who Frank Sinatra was. Now, I can't believe that nobody knows who Frank Sinatra is.
Well, her mother was an actress, and you...
Maureen O'Sullivan.
Yeah, so you can't tell me that the mother didn't know. I mean, that was in her, repertoire at that time. So, Mia Farrow. Well,
and for those of you that don't remember Maureen O'Sullivan, I'm sorry.
O'Sullivan.
She was Jane in the Tarzan movies.
Yeah.
So... Yeah, you're right. She had a show business background.
Absolutely. Beautiful woman.
Very great actress.
Oh, yes.
Put
absolutely.
Up with Tarzan.
Oh, really?
They didn't have deodorant in the jungle, so she...
And listen, he had to wipe his feet on the leaves because they didn't have any doormats or, and no shoes.
Had to put up with Cheetah.
Yeah, Cheetah. Oh. There's a commercial. I don't remember which one it is, but he's flying through the jungle, and there's a girl with him. And she asks him where the river is. She asks a monkey, a gorilla, or whatever.
Right.
And I don't know whether he's eating a banana. He just shakes his head, no. A river, do you know where the river is? And he keeps saying, I'm Tarzan. I'm the one. Ask me. I'm the one.
They got lost.
And then they got lost. They got lost. Right. And so they grab onto this rope that's hanging, and he yells to Tarzan, whatever. And she said, you always have to yell in my ear as they're swinging through. That was that reminded me. It was terrific. Yeah.
I don't forget what commercial.
Yeah, it's
is.
A commercial.
That's a good one.
It's a commercial. Yeah, you'll see it on TV. Yeah. So, yeah, that's funny.
Oh, Bev.
Let's see. Now, did Dean Martin ever sing Frank's songs that he sang, or he had a separate repertoire?
They really had a separate repertoire. They rarely did the same songs. I never heard Frank sing a Dean song or Dean sing a Frank song. Once in a great while, when Frank would guest appear on the Dean Martin Show,
Was fun. I remember that.
Remember that every Thursday
night.
They
said, "Jump on the piano."
Yes.
Come in one door, then jump on the piano. So, yeah.
No, but to your point, they drew the line, and even Sammy, they all drew the line. Yeah. They didn't step on each other.
Well, Sammy Davis Jr. sang different songs that showed his real strength.
Yes.
You know, he had a terrific voice.
Oh, fantastic.
He was not a tall man of stature,
no.
But he could belt out a song incredibly. You didn't even need a microphone. You could really hear him.
He could sing, he could dance. He could tap dance, yep. He can act.
And he was a little kid. He started out like 3 years old.
Oh, yeah, the Will Maston Trio.
And his dad, dad was in the business and brought him in. So that was incredible. Yeah, the voices and the songs. I don't know if they would be able to blend together because each one by itself was just a masterpiece. Was an entire orchestra.
Oh, yeah.
It was an entire orchestra.
Oh, yeah.
It was beautiful. Yeah, it was beautiful. So if if Dean Martin, do you have any that Dean Martin sang? Are you going to sing tonight any from Dean Martin?
I gave Ken the Sinatra CD, but
Sinatra's good.
Yeah,
No, I just wanted to see, you know, the.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, okay. That's amore.
That's good. Okay. No, Sinatra's good. We'll do Sinatra all this evening. This is good. How many records did he sell? Do you know?
Over 1,200. Oh, he sold? I don't know. He recorded over 1,200.
Any platinum, gold, platinum albums?
He did, but it wasn't for a long time. And, you know, shame on me, I forgot what his first platinum record was.
Well, Las Vegas, I think he was good in person.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, good in person. Oh, I don't think the recordings, the recordings are important, but people wanted to see him live. It was like Elvis, you know. I'm not an Elvis fan, but they wanted to see him wiggle. They wanted to see him whatever he does, you know. But Sinatra, it was just his attitude, his movement. He was a class act, is what I'm trying to say. They wanted to see that class act. They were paying good money, and they wanted to see a class act for that.
Well, and to your point, and you're 1,000% right, and what Frank Sinatra did, every woman who came from one of his shows would say, it was like he was singing to me.
Oh, yeah, the visuals.
And he actually was. What Frank Sinatra would do is he would make eye contact with almost every woman that he possibly could in the audience.
Yeah.
And he would sing to them. And then he'd look at this one and sing to her. Oh, yeah. And they'd come out of there in a cloud.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And to your point, that's why they wanted to see him, because he had those deep blue eyes. Oh. And he'd stare right at the women, and they would just go nuts.
Yeah, that's terrific.
See, with Elvis, it was the shaking. To your point,
shaking,
with Sinatra,
sure.
It was the eyes.
No, I wasn't. See, I mean, the Bobby Soxers then, whatever, that was a whole different era.
Oh, yeah.
You know? He was the generation before, and sang, you know, all those songs, the military stuff, and it was good. I mean, the 30s, the 40s, that was a wonderful musical time. Good music came out of that time, and they can't reproduce that. Now,
no.
If you just yell and swear in a microphone, everybody goes crazy.
So
yay, hooray.
And they make a lot of money.
And they make they don't even know, I don't know if I even told you that, Chief Keef, rapper, he was renting a house right in my backyard. And he could say and swear, and they were throwing money at him. 18 years old, he had like $10 million, $20 million. They didn't know what to do for him. I mean, you know, we didn't understand anything he was saying. My husband, I must tell you, thought he was an excellent singer.
Really?
I said, Kenny, do you even know what he's singing about? He said, I don't know, but he says a good voice.
Well, he's open-minded.
Well, that's all right. I mean, he believe me, we're not of that generation.
Yeah,
but
you and me both.
Okay, so, and he make three. So, you know, I guess he didn't want to hurt anybody's feelings. But, you know, TL swear and whatever, in these microphones that they hurt my ears. I can't even turn it down a little bit. There's nothing that even, you know, conjures up any kind of, you know, romantic emotion, you know. No, this is screaming, yelling, carrying on. Let's rip the building down. Let's, you know.
Shoot this guy.
Yeah, let's bomb the street. Let's blow out the tires. And everybody's got weapons in hand. They think this is a joke. Reality, this is not a joke.
No, it's not.
I must give the police a round of applause because they did keep us safe when the time that they needed to.
Yeah.
And we had everybody and their uncle attached to law enforcement, DEA, CIA, FBI, Highland Park Police, Chicago Police, Lake County Sheriff's Police. Everybody came. When they were evicted, they had to leave quickly, and they did. So that's our experience with rappers, right up close
not a
and
good one.
Right up close and personal in your face. Yeah,
not a good one, Ben.
No, this is not my style. But let's hear some more, Frank. What are you going to sing now?
Oh my goodness! Whatever's next, I'll sing what I'll surprise myself.
Okay, good.
Oh, here we go. Oh, this is a great one. Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I'll show you around. You'll love it, bet your bottom dollar you'll lose your blues in Chicago. Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday could not shut down. On State Street, that great street, I just want to say, you'll see things you won't find on Broadway. Hey, you'll have the time of your life. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago, Chicago, my hometown. Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, I'll show you around. You'll love it, bet your bottom dollar you'll lose your blues in Chicago. Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday could not shut down. On State Street, that great street, I just want to say, you'll see things you won't find on Broadway. You'll have the time of your life. I saw a man, he danced with his wife in Chicago. Chicago, Chicago, my hometown, Illinois. Fun song.
Yeah, and these songs tell a story.
Right.
And maybe our viewers are too young, they don't know. Who was Billy Sunday? Do you know who Billy Sunday was?
Billy Sunday was a preacher, and he was during the Prohibition era.
Prohibition.
Yeah.
That's right.
And of course, they tried to.
Absolutely.
Good luck closing down 10,000 speakeasies.
You know, and the reason for that is because the voice of the people had to be heard. They couldn't prohibit the alcohol. They were making bathtub gin.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they were doing whatever they had to do. People were going blind.
Oh, yeah.
They were drinking straight alcohol.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, there was no preservation for the one who was drinking it. They were just drinking alcohol. Because the country said, no, in Illinois, it said, no, we're going to do it anyway. What are you talking about? So, you know, they had to conform. And, you know, Elliot Ness with all of his goodies.
Oh, yeah.
What can I say?
Well, Prohibition was the birth of the mixed drink.
No, I didn't know that.
There were never Manhattans and highballs and old fashions and daiquiris. What happened was, to your point, the booze tasted so bad.
Yeah, anything.
That they had to flavor it.
Yeah.
So all of a sudden they're putting in all these blue and red and green flavors.
Oh.
And people started, so they're drinking it. Terrible as it tasted, it covered up the taste.
Okay.
So when booze became legal, then they started getting creative with all these recipes.
See.
But.
And listen, there's money in everything. That was a wonderful idea.
Absolutely.
President Kennedy's father, wasn't he doing bootlegging from Canada or whatever?
Allegedly, he was a bootlegger. That's how he got to start. Allegedly.
Yeah. Allegedly.
Yes,
right.
I use that term.
Well, the money isn't allegedly. The money is actually and physically and there in your hand. Oh, my God. Yeah, these songs from those eras of the 20s or the 30s, they told stories.
Oh, yes.
They told the real happenings of what was going on. People liked the melody, but the story was there.
The birth of jazz.
Oh, yeah.
Which is rumored to have started in Bronzeville.
Bronzeville? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I know that blues, the blues, and nothing to do with the Blues Brothers, but I thought that was in Louisiana. How did that?
New Orleans.
New Orleans, yeah. How did that filter up? So
I'm not sure because Chicago, St. Louis, New Orleans, they all have their own blues.
Yeah.
So I don't know how they do it. Yeah.
Wow, that was incredible. See, everything has its timelines, but you know. I think for the kids, they used to have the 45s. Everybody used to go out and get the 45s.
Right, I remember.
Everybody buying 40. It used to be 99 cents.
I remember. Get a Beatles record for 99 cents.
Could you believe it? I used to have a stack of, every week, I'd be doing babysitting, and the money I made for babysitting, used to buy a 45 right away. Some dumb song on one side, and the other side was the smash hit. They had to pair it up because they couldn't unload the other song. What are they going to do? So it was a different timeline.
And it was two songs because it was a two-sided.
Two sides, of course.
Yeah.
And I said, one side, who knew even the artist or whatever? And then, of course, the other side was, the Supremes or, whatever else. Yeah, that was good.
45s.
The 45s.
That was before 8-tracks.
Well, 33 and a thirds. What about the 78s?
Remember the 78s? They were about that big.
I know. I've got 78s. I've got 33s. I've even got a couple. I have some 45s. So.
Oh, those are collector's items.
I know. Me too. I'm a collector's item.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Not you both.
Very nice, thank you. That's why we have Jack on the program. I need him perched on my shoulder to tell me every day this. But if you want to see Jack and you've got a cable, you can see him on my YouTube. And we invite you to do step inside the world of YouTube. And here it is, www.youtube.com/NorthShoreLiveCCCoopersCorner. And when this program, which we are doing live, is after the fact, then you can see Jack anywhere in the world. He'll be on everywhere in the world. And we so appreciate his beautiful singing. Other people need to know he exists as well.
And thank you, Bev.
This is true, Jack. This is so true.
Thank you.
Christina, you married a wonderful, wonderful man and a beautiful voice. And a good soul. This is outstanding.
Thank you.
Outstanding.
You know, the funny thing is now that I'm glad you brought Christina up, because you know Christina and I, we sing together.
I know.
We sing for our parish every week, every Sunday. It's just her and I. It's not a choir. It's just Christina and I. Yeah. And then all the festivals coming up in the summer, it's her and I.
How nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
How
we'll
nice.
Be doing Oakley Boulevard in June. Be doing Melrose Park, Feast of Our Lady of Mount Carmel in July. We'll be doing the Addison Fest in August. I've got one coming up in Joliet in June. Yeah.
You're traveling all over.
All over, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, we, Yeah, we do all. And it's funny because, you know, she doesn't like me talking about her, but she, when we met, she didn't know I was a singer, and I didn't know she was a singer.
Oh.
The way she found out I was a singer is it was one of our first dates. We went to Tuscany, where I used to sing. I sang there for 2 years in Oak Brook. Great piano player by the name of Miles Green. Mm. So Miles was there, and he said, "You want to? You know, we had dinner, great dinner, and then we went to the bar, and he said, "You want to sing a song?" And I said, "Fine." So I sang, and that's how Christina found out. Now, the way I found out she was a singer is we were by the music director at our parish. We were by her house. So she wanted to know how this one song in Polish went, because it was a Polish melody. Well, okay. Christina knows them all. So she started singing, and the music director looked at her and said, "Why aren't you singing in the choir?" Huh. Well, she works up in Highland Park, so she doesn't have time to drive down to practice.
Sure.
But they took her. Every week she sings with, she and I sing together now because they liked her voice so much.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
So it's nice to be married to somebody who understands.
Oh, music, sure, exactly. Absolutely. Exactly. Yeah, this is great. Two of a kind, you see that?
Two of a kind.
Absolutely, two of a kind. the songs that, now I heard you sing at Pat's house. You sang a duet with Christina.
Yes.
It was a Polish song. And you were singing the English, and she was singing the Polish? I didn't understand.
Actually, it was both of us singing both.
Ah.
Moja droga, ja cię kocham, the Bobby Vinton song.
The Bobby Vinton, that was it. That was it. That was the song. How cute. That was so cute.
Means you met Pat Mahowski's party.
Oh,
wasn't that wonderful?
That was outstanding. Her 85th birthday, yeah. That was outstanding.
There were so many people in that room. I remember thinking of, and I even said this to everybody, I had an MRI the week before.
Oh, sure.
And I said, you know, I said in a good way, I said, being in this room makes me think that MRI was why I had more room in the MRI than
that's
I had
right.
In
you know
that
how
room.
It was so close in there. But everybody found a seat to sit
yeah.
in. But it was packed. It was packed.
Well, because everybody, like you and me,
right.
Everybody loves Pat.
Yeah. You needed a shoehorn to get anybody else in. We'll squeeze it in some
Remember
way.
My
we'll
piano
just
player was
Oh, I saw he was.
Yeah.
That was good. Oh, yeah. That
yeah,
was
Christina
good.
And I sang that together.
Yeah,
and then
that
we
was
sang
good.
Nice and Easy.
Yeah.
We do
that
all
good.
The time. Yeah.
That was good. That was beautiful.
Pat Mahowski, what a doll.
Yeah, she is. You guys have got to get on together to sing, you and Christina.
Oh, we will.
So,
one
we'll,
day she'll come
we'll,
on.
We'll do a part three.
We'll do a part
this
three.
This is only part two, but we'll do a part three. You both have to come on to sing because it's beautiful. Absolutely, absolutely. Just terrific. Yeah, you and everybody enjoyed it. Everybody, and you had so many different cultures because Pat worked for the governor's office, but
yes.
She was in cultural, you know, diversity or whatever.
Yes.
And so everything she was doing had all these other cultures that really, you know, was the importance of her position in the office. So she had German people,
yes.
Indian,
yes.
the doctor from...
Dr. Arana.
Yeah.
He was Cardinal Bernardine's cancer surgeon.
Okay. So he was there. His wife was there.
Yes.
Everybody came with couples and different cultures. It was... But you guys were a smash. It was one... And it was so hot. Do you remember? Somebody was playing with the air conditioning... And instead of putting it on cool and air conditioning, they put it up to 85 degrees. They put it on heat, and we were sweating bullets. We were sitting right next to the air conditioner, which we thought was going to be cooling. And I was just drizzling. It was just, but we listened to you, and we applauded because it was beautiful.
Well, thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, it was beautiful.
Pat used to have, in the governor's mansion, we would go every year. She would have a special dinner on St. Joseph's Day.
Yeah.
Now, St. Joseph's Day, besides being a Catholic holiday, is very important for the Polish community and the Italian community. So half the people in the room would be Polish, half the people in the room would be Italian. They would enter, I sang, there were Polish dancers, there was Italian singers, Polish singers, and she would put this together, and she did this, it was... couple of governors she did this with. It stopped when Blagojevich got in office. He put a stop to it. I guess there was not enough in the budget. But it was so sad because she did such a wonderful job.
There were plenty
job.
Of Italians and plenty of Polish people.
Oh, yeah.
I think Illinois is has more people from Poland, the population, than Poland has, because everybody came to Chicago. But I attended a couple of those, but it used to be downtown Chicago.
Oh, sure, by it, the...
That was, what was it?
Federal building or what? No, what?
It was on the, I don't know...
The State of Illinois
State
building.
State of Illinois building.
That's where it was.
That's where, yes.
And that was Judy Bart Topinka who put that together then.
And, yes. And I came with a friend of mine who was the baker, Tom Vitello,
Italian.
Yeah. And so we sat with the Italian side. I said, we had to go to the Polish side, then sit with the Italian side. It's, you know, whichever way you're going, you're going to get good food.
Oh, yeah,
food
either way.
Was lined up from one end of the world to the other.
Oh, yeah.
It was terrific. It was very good. And I think that was a wonderful blending of all the cultures. We need that. We need that today. We need more of that today. She did the right thing. That was a wonderful thing to do. That was brilliant of her.
She was. She's a good woman.
That was brilliant to be able to do that.
Jude, can I tell you a quick story about Judy Bart Topinka?
Oh, yeah. I know Judy well.
Actually, two quick stories.
I know Judy well. I knew her well, yeah.
Wonderful. Yeah. You know, she was a phenomenal piano player?
No, but accordion, every time she came out, I said, Judy, where's your accordion? Oh, next time, Bev, next time. I said, You're a controller of the. I said, you know, I'll come down. You'll take me through the department, and I just want to run through the money barefoot. I just want to run through it barefoot. I said, could we go on a shopping spree? She said, well, I got to tell you something. No more cash. Everything is credit card.
Yeah.
I said, well, and the state doesn't
so
even have
that.
So I said, well, you know, you're sitting here, but what can you offer me? I mean, I'm offering you the world and everybody who sees you. So, but she was a doll.
Oh,
she
nice
was a doll.
Person.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And her son, Joe, and his family, our condolences out to him.
Yeah.
She was outstanding. An
Agreed.
Outstanding lady.
Agreed.
You know, she used to say, I'm just coming off the road. I've been, you know, I'm all over in all of the 102 counties of Illinois. She says, you wouldn't even know what my car looks like or what the van looks like. I said, why? She said, because you have to step over Whopper sandwiches and the McDonald's drinks and what and Arby's and whatever. I said, but Judy, does it get you from one place to another? She said, sure. I said, so what does anybody care?
That's right.
The car has wheels and you'll drive. You'll clean it out when you get home. Don't worry about it. And she didn't have to worry about getting into office. Everybody loved her. Everybody wanted her. Yeah, we made a big plaque for Judy. It's a Judy Bart Topinka. Yeah, big bronze plaque for her desk. And, you know, the longer the name, the larger the plaque.
The plaque, sure.
It took up the whole desk. She said, oh, my God, where am I going to put this? But we made that bronze plaque for her, that desk plate, absolutely. Not just a little bitty. We made a nice desk plate for her. Big person, big heart, and good deeds.
Big person.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, absolutely. Small in stature. Judy wasn't very tall.
No, didn't weigh a lot.
No. She was a gung-ho redhead, but, you know.
Yeah. Very gung-ho.
But just outstanding personality. Interesting, you know, the people that you meet along the way, everybody, anybody, whatever, everybody has something to put in to help other people.
Yes.
And she had a wonderful personality and a great poise and very
down to earth,
very understanding of everyone. It
yes.
was it was terrific.
Yeah.
Maybe we should dedicate this song, this whatever you're going to sing now, to Judy Bart Topinka.
I have to tell you this quick story before.
Sure, go ahead.
When Judy ran the St. Joseph's Day, Judy and Pat ran the St. Joseph's Day down at the State of Illinois building.
Yeah.
Ron Onesti was there, and he said, you need to sing a song to Judy. I said, great. He said, what are you going to sing? I said, well, I'll sing Ladies of Tramp, but I'll change the name to Champ.
Oh, Champ, okay.
He said, don't do it.
Oh.
I said, why? He said, because you're going to forget.
And then sing the word. Oh, my
and
goodness.
So now I start singing the song. There was 600 people.
Oh, I know.
I was there.
It was loaded.
Packed.
Yeah, it was there.
So sure enough, I'm standing next to Judy, And instead of singing Champ,
you didn't.
My mind went back.
Oh, you didn't.
And I called her in front of 600 people. I called her a tramp.
Oh, no. Oh,
the state
no.
treasurer. I called her a tramp.
Oh, no. Oh, no. All right, Jack. All right. How did you make good on that then?
Yeah, but you know what? She enjoyed that story. She always reminded me every time I saw her.
Oh, my goodness sakes. How could you? Oh. Well, it probably wouldn't have come out as good if you'd have changed it anyway.
You're right.
Well, the feeling. Oh, God. All right. So what are you going to sing now?
I have no idea what's next, but okay. It'll surprise me.
All right. Go ahead and let's be surprised.
Oh, here we go. Come fly with me. Let's fly. Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in Far Bombay. Come on, fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me. Let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll do his flute for you. Come on, fly with me. Let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide so starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so awfully near. You might even a band of angels cheer, because we're together weather-wise. It's such a perfect day. You say those words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. Oh, it's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they do say. Come on, fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
Yeah, that's a fascinating
song. That's a nice song, yeah.
You know, one of the airlines used that.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, one of the, I'm not sure which one it is, but they used that as their commercial.
Oh.
Yeah, so now I don't even know the airlines, if they're even the same. One merges with the other, The other went down, so... I don't know.
Yeah, they all own each other now.
I know. But that music, that was Frank Sinatra. I'm going to say Pan Am or TWA, or I don't even know if they're in business anymore.
Neither one.
And Northwest Orient, that's not even around
neither
anymore.
Neither one.
What is there, a Seagull?
Well, there's United, which merged with Continental. There's American, which merged with U.S. Airlines.
American.
Northwest merged with Delta.
Oh.
Those are the three big ones. And then you have Southwest, and you've got the rest.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. So, you know, did he make any songs about a train? Maybe, there is a song about a train.
No, that was Doris Day, Chattanooga Choo Choo.
Chattanooga, yeah.
No, I'm sorry. No. That was... Glenn Miller, Chattanooga, or was it? Yeah, Glenn Miller, Chattanooga Choo Choo. Doris Day was Sentimental Journey.
That was
about
the
being
one,
on a train.
Sentimental Journey. Yeah.
Railroad track that takes me back.
And
yeah.
That was it.
No, Frank loved to fly.
He was all over. He was flying all over.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Always somewhere.
Yeah. I mean, he wasn't just, in the United States. He went all over
to
Europe.
World.
Everybody heard him. He made wonderful, performances. People loved him. In any language.
Oh, yeah.
They American, and Frank Sinatra, I mean, a movie star, how nice.
To your point, if Frank never sang one song, he would be remembered as a great actor.
Yes.
Because he starred in so many movies. And he, like you said, The Man with the Golden Arm, what a phenomenal acting
that
job.
That was terrific.
Oh.
That was a terrific picture. Yeah. Well,
and he did his homework. He spent time watching heroin addicts go cold turkey.
Yeah.
That one scene where he was kicking the habit,
Kim Novak locked him in the closet. Did you remember she locked him in the closet? And, it was incredible.
Speaking of Polish people from Chicago, Kim Novak came from Milwaukee Avenue.
That's right. Yeah. My brother went to Wright Junior College with her.
Oh, you're kidding.
No, I wish I was, but it's the truth, you know. But, yeah.
Was she a nice person, do you know?
He said she was an eye catcher. He wasn't looking at her personality.
Okay, all right.
She was an eye catcher. Yeah, yeah, she was an eye catcher.
Very famous.
Yes, absolutely. He did, all the guys liked her a lot, a whole lot. She was the only one, I think, I saw on TV. They were doing a celebrity information thing. She kept her last name. She said her father wanted her to keep her true name, and Novak is her real last name.
That's right.
So I think her first name was Marilyn, but I'm not sure if that's true.
That's correct.
Yeah, Marilyn.
That's exactly right.
But there was because two blondes, Marilyn Monroe and Marilyn Novak, so they changed it.
Well, in Sinatra, his mother made him keep his last name.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he wanted to change his name. She said, no.
Yeah.
You were born with that name, you're going to die with
it.
That name.
Yeah.
Frank Sinatra. That was Francis Albert Sinatra.
Yeah, Francis Albert, yeah. They were playing something on the radio today for him, and I don't remember what it was, but I remember they said Francis Albert Sinatra.
Yeah.
So, and I either came in or was going out, and I heard that last thing. I don't know what they were playing. I wish I would have just stayed, but to listen, because I really like. If I have some place to go, and I have to tell you this, this is just who I am. If I have somewhere to go, and if the radio isn't playing the song that I'm, you know, too terribly interested in, mm-hmm. then I can leave or do my laundry or whatever I'm doing. But if it's going to play something that I like, I have to sit down to listen to it. And I listen to it to the very end. And I'm looking at my watch. I have to, I got to listen to this. So really, this is the truth.
It takes you to a nice place.
Yeah, and so wherever I have to go, I get in the car, I still hum the song, whatever it is. Yeah, it's really nice. It's that's just who I am. That's my dedication. I like that a lot.
You got culture and you like culture.
Yeah.
That's why you like the arts and entertainment.
Yeah.
That's why you have this wonderful show.
Well, we hope so. It's a good 35 years.
35 years,
this is
Feb,
a long
that's
time
wonderful.
Show. And I'm the original, one of the originals I'm the only one, let's put it that way, that's still here, 35 years. Everybody else came and went and tried their best, but I'm doing this 35 years live, and I enjoy it. And it's a community. Input, people like to hear, like to see things going on in the community, like to be aware. There's news. The news isn't always good news,
right.
But it brings people to the watch. But this is happy news. This is good things in the community.
And it's their community, your community.
Absolutely.
They're not hearing about halfway around the world.
No.
They're hearing about down the block.
Absolutely, absolutely. This is on the North Shore, things that go on here. And why not? I mean, this is... people want to come up this way, so.
Well, and to your point, the North Shore has their own magazine, so to your point,
absolutely.
They got their own TV show.
That's right, absolutely.
Cooper's Corner.
That's right, absolutely. 35 years.
35 years.
And I tell everybody I'm still 18, or maybe 21, but, I told everybody I'm 18, so 18's okay.
So, you started when you were a teenager.
That's right, this is, I'm a teenager, that's okay. I'm still a teenager. That's right.
You're as young as you feel.
That's right, absolutely, even though I like Frank Sinatra, what is he, 100 already? I don't know, but
his 100th birthday was December 12th of last year.
Okay.
We did a large show at the Arcata Theater in St. Charles on December 12th. 2015,
birthday.
Which was his 100th birthday, and it was sold out, over 900 people.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah.
Oh my
Christina
goodness.
Was there.
Ooh,
yeah, she took pictures and videos. Over 900 people, Christina, right?
Oh my goodness sakes!
Yeah.
Oh my goodness sakes!
Yeah.
Incredible.
Yeah, just packed the place.
And his son, I read recently, just passed away. Yeah. What was that? What was he? Did he have an illness, a disease?
It was his heart. Let me show you this real quick. I don't know if the camera could pick this up or not. This was taken in October at the Arcata Theater. Ron Onesti introduced us to Frank Jr. because we were doing a show about his father 2 months later.
Oh, my
That picture
gosh.
Was taken 4 months before he passed away.
I don't
away.
Know if you could see that.
That's Frank Jr.
Frank Jr.
I got my arm
Wait,
around
yeah,
him.
Yeah, he's right there.
Can you pick that? Yeah, I've got my arm around
yeah,
him.
Look at that. Oh, my God. Isn't that incredible?
Nice man.
Really?
Yeah, very nice
You man. Know, he has a history with him that he was kidnapped and all this.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, they didn't know. They only asked, what, $250,000 for him.
Right.
But, you know, I would have thought they would have asked, you know, more, but...
those guys, they, and, you know...
And they paid him off. They paid him. He brought the money, and they paid him off.
And, you know, I show you the kind of guy that Frank Sinatra is. Everybody, some... Not everybody, but some people give Sinatra a bad rap because he knew all kinds of people.
Oh, yeah.
On both sides of the law. When his son got kidnapped, his own flesh and blood, he got a call from J. Edgar Hoover... Oh. He got a call from Attorney General Robert Kennedy,
oh, yeah,
and he
yeah,
got
yeah.
a call from Sam Giancana.
Oh,
and all three Giancana. Of them said, how can we help you, Frank?
Yeah.
Now, can you imagine?
Giancana.
Yeah. All he had to do was tell Sam Giancana, hey, these guys kidnapped my son.
Go get him.
There would have been no trial.
No.
Yeah. Or even if he told J. Edgar Hoover. I mean, those guys would have...
They went.
They would have went for forever.
That's incredible.
And then when they finally let him go, to your point, then they said it was all a hoax. It was set up by Frank Jr. as a publicity stunt. You talk about insult on top of injury?
Wow.
So what the family went through was, and this was, by the way, December of 63. It happened 2 or 3 weeks after the Kennedy assassination,
yeah. I remember seeing the newsreel on that, and Nancy Sinatra was so shook by the situation. The reporters wanted to talk with her, but she declined and just went into the house. She just couldn't. She said she just wants to be with her son. She just wants to be with him.
Yeah.
So that was, you know, with any of these kidnappings, that's heartbreaking. And with any of the, well, the assassinations, that's one right after the other that was bad.
Yes.
Between the... President Kennedy, and then yes. Bobby Kennedy,
yes.
and I think Teddy Kennedy, they said he better not run for president because it was the Kennedy curse, so-called the Kennedy curse.
Yeah.
So anyway, I want to hear some more music. We only have 5 minutes left.
That's all?
I'm telling you. You just wanted to talk. I want to hear the music. We can always talk, Jack.
Well, you want to save it for the one last song we close the show with? You want to close it with My Way, or how do you
well,
want to do it? Whatever you like.
Whatever you want to do. We'll do 5 minutes, and then if we have a couple minutes to go, go ahead.
This is the absolute fastest hour of my life.
Well, we're going to do part three. Christina's got to come.
Christina's going to come on the next show.
Absolutely,
yes.
Next show. Okay.
Yes.
All right, this is going to be My Way. Is that what you're going to do? With?
Whatever you want to.
Vic, whatever you want to put on.
If you could put on, it's track number 11. Now, the end is near, so I face the final curtain. My friends, I'll say it clear, state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I've traveled each and every highway, but more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all, and I stood tall, and did it my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing. But now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not. To say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way. Written by Paul Anka for Frank Sinatra.
Really?
Yeah.
Paul, I didn't even know that.
Paul Anka wrote that song for Frank.
What was the expression from that? I mean, what was the reasoning from that?
Just admire, mutual admiration.
And Paul, he did it for him.
He did it for Frank. That was Frank's song. That was written for Frank.
For him.
Yeah.
Wow. What a dynamic song. Powerful, dynamic, and...
Perfect for Frank.
Perfect for Frank, absolutely. Yeah. Oh, my goodness sakes. Okay, we don't have much time.
Are we out of time already?
Again, what can I say? Let's just tell our friends, you can connect with Jack.
Absolutely.
He has a, there it is.
There it is right there.
www.jackmuccio.com. And if you like these songs as much as I, and you want to connect and hear more of his songs and more of what he does, please do contact. And we will have a part three, I can assure you.
We'll I look forward to it.
Oh, and this time, Christina's
with
gonna
Christina.
Be absolutely, so we're going to do it. We want to thank you for allowing us in your home, your place of business, and for you to enjoy this beautiful, beautiful vocal. And I told you, Chicago's number one Caruso, absolutely a Caruso. So see you next week on North Shore Live, Cooper's Corner. Be safe, be healthy, and you enjoyed yourself for this evening's program. See you next time on North Shore Live, Cooper's Corner.
Bye-bye.
Good evening. Bye-bye. Yeah, that was fast.
Damn.